Moving to our special focus on the show tonight. Perhaps nothing illustrates the story of two Indias more than this. 465 children are dead in Uttar Pradesh in the last 3 months, and an estimated 10 children die every day. Yet it's hardly created a ripple in our polity or in our corridors of power at the center or in the state. Can you imagine the reaction if even 10 children had died in Delhi or Mumbai of an easily preventable viral disease? The cause for encephalitis is simple. It's poor hygiene. It's spread then by mosquitoes. Vaccines are available. They're ordered every year, yet often are redundant because they expire before they are used. This number of children dead should be unacceptable in our country. What is the response on this? Well, today the health minister came visiting, apparently ordered to do so by Rahul Gandhi. The chief minister hasn't been yet. In fact, she hasn't even uttered a word on this since this year's epidemic. Is a child's life of different value if he or she is poor?
ज्यादा बच्चे मर रहे हैं और रोज चार पांच छह तो उनको मेरी आंखों के सामने से जा रहे हैं। इंसेफ्लाइटिस के लिए स्पेशल वार्ड जो है और बड़ा जो बनवा दें ताकि मरीजों को जो है दिक्कतें ना हो।
अपनी आंखों के सामने अपने बच्चों को मरते हुए देख के कैसा लगता है ये हम जान रहे हैं अच्छी तरीके से।
A visit apparently on Rahul Gandhi's intervention. But are both the center and state guilty of complete apathy to an epidemic which returns every year? An official estimate says that 50,000 lives have been lost to encephalitis in the last 33 years. This year, nearly 500 children have died of the deadly virus.
Facilities you cannot provide for so many people at a time in emergency.
All sorts of actions by fogging and bleaching, chlorination, all sorts of actions will take place.
The virus is carried by mosquitoes and vast amounts of money are required to keep these villages sanitized. This time the state government has given 22 crore rupees for more wards, but it may be too little too late as the disease strikes in the monsoon, which is over. 22 crore rupees were sanctioned this year for a dedicated encephalitis ward and 100 new beds. But on the ground, little has changed. Despite the virus spreading in new areas, 33,000 vaccines still lie unused, while 15 lakh have expired. Dr. R.N. Singh, who has been fighting to eradicate encephalitis in the state, has now resorted to writing letters in blood to the central government.
We are very grateful that Health Minister has visited this day. We want from him to do is, one, to launch a national program for its eradication, two, to get the J vaccine done in the month of December 2011.
The writing on the wall is that this is a national medical emergency. Officials have told us that the virus is now spreading by around 20 to 30 kilometers per year. But because it afflicts the India of poverty and hunger, it is perhaps easy to look the other way. In Gorakhpur, with Saleem and Ramesh, this is Sonal Mehrotra for NDTV.
Why is it that the rest of India doesn't seem to care? Forget the rest of India, even in Lucknow, the voices of these children, their parents, hasn't reached yet. Joining me on the debate tonight is Dr. V.M. Katoch. He's Secretary of the Government of India and the Department of Health Research. I'm also joined by Harsh Mandar, a well-known activist writer who's written often on why public policy in India seems so skewed against the poor. Also joining me, Kiran Mazumdar-Shaw, a chairperson of Biocon Limited, one of the world's best-known biotechnology firms. And of course, she also runs the Biocon Foundation, which works in the areas of health. Thank you all very much for joining me. Dr. Katoch, if I can go across to you first. 465 children dead just this year alone. As our reporter says, 10 children at an estimate die every day in one hospital in Gorakhpur. Why has the response been so muted? Why has India not reacted? And where is the government?
See, I think it's not fair to say that India has not reacted. India has been trying to do its best, but the problem is very different and gingetic. You know, when the causes of the encephalitis are not one JE, actually, there are more than 100 viruses. And even within the, whether you talk of Gorakhpur region, adjoining area of Bihar, you talk of Assam, there are a number of viruses which are responsible. Now, for the JE part, the vaccinations last year have been fairly done, it covered quite a bit actually, and the JE per se has come down actually. The deaths for the JE have been less, but the other encephalitis, which is due to the waterborne viruses, that has not changed much actually, unfortunately, because that needs a different kind of a total war against the, see, the pure the war, the water has to be, I think, portable. It has to be free from bacteria, viruses.
So you're making,
that's a massive,
you're making, sir, the yes. medical point that there are issues coming of the virus mutating, and that is a valid point, and I'm sure it is difficult, but
I'm not talking about I'm not talking of viruses mutating. I'm talking of the multiple reasons for encephalitis.
Yes.
And acute encephalitis syndrome is caused by more than 100 viruses. And at least 6 groups are important in India. J is one of them.
Mm-hmm.
J is preventable by vaccine to a large extent. And wherever the vaccine is used, it has shown a decline. But there, you know, it has entered into the new areas. So obviously, you have to cover a much larger spectrum. And
when you hear, sir, as in our report, that 15 lakh vaccines have expired, that means that these vaccines were bought, they were put into a cupboard somewhere in some government hospital or building in these areas, and they haven't been used. What would your reaction be to that as a doctor?
I really don't know whether this happened, actually. I'm not aware of that. Such a vaccine has not been used, actually. But by and large, vaccination in India, because the children are to be immunized, and J is one of them in those areas. So the immunization in certain areas in the country is lacking as such also. That's, I think, the whole system is to be strengthened. But I'm not aware of these figures, actually, so exactly. But in general, the immunization is to be strengthened. There's no doubt on that part.
NDTV's cricket app. Android and iPhone. Fastest scorecard. Special analysis. And much more. Download free. NDTV.com/apps.